the Ukrainian military will receive the Slinger anti-drone system manufactured by Australian company Electro Optic Systems, according to Matt Jones, EOS Executive Vice President for Defense System. The company has been conducting trials of the system for the past 3 weeks near Sydney. The Slinger system is based on an M230LF 30mm cannon and a MAG-58 7.62mm machine gun, and is mounted on a GMC Denali pickup truck. While the number of M230LF cannons is increasing in the U.S. military, a number of international customers are showing strong interest in the lightweight 30mm weapon, originally developed as an automatic cannon for the AH-64 Apache helicopter, and later rejected in link-fed versions for land and naval roles. John McCollum, Director of Business Development for the Weapons Operations Unit at Northrop Grumman, stated in an online update briefing, "With the M230LF operating in various combat environments, the U.S. military, designating it XM914, has issued a request for information for additional mobile low, slow, small unmanned aircraft integrated defeat system, MLIDS. This system utilizes a Northrop Grumman chain gun as a powerful anti-UAS effector, weighing less than 73 kilograms without ammunition and with a recoil force of less than 7,400 newtons, it can be mounted on many RCWS designed to accommodate 12.7 millimeters heavy machine guns. The M230LF chain gun can fire single shots, controlled bursts, and fully automatic. In fully automatic mode, the rate of fire reaches 200 rounds per minute and provides a lethal range of over 2,000 meters. To provide multi-role capabilities to the Apache, a high-explosive dual-purpose HEDP round was developed, which has proven effective against Class 1 UAS as well," said Michael Hafton, Director of Ammunition Business Development at Northrop Grumman. "This ammunition ensures good performance against medium armor while maintaining fragmentation effects. However, to increase the M230LF effectiveness against UAS and expand its capabilities, several improvements to both the weapon and the ammunition are planned. One of the initial issues relates to potential interference with the electrical priming system by electronic warfare systems and radars, typically installed on RCWS dedicated to CUAS missions. To address this issue, about 18 months ago, the M230LF became available in a primed percussion version," explained Michael Hafton. "Further development of the ammunition is underway. A programmable airburst ammunition is being designed, which adds the ability to engage targets in emergencies, such as infantry behind cover. Northrop Grumman is also developing guided munitions," Michael Hafton explained. "This program is being run jointly with the U.S. Army and U.S. Navy. The goal is to extend short-range technology to a new level of guidance that will bring the round closer to the target and increase its lethality. Guided munitions development is currently at TRL 5, and the company is targeting a TRL 7 demonstration. The 30mm M230LF, Northrop Grumman is developing a 20mm version known as the Sky Viper. According to the company, the program was delayed due to funding issues, but those issues have now been resolved and will be restarted, with a prototype expected within the next 18 months. This gun is being considered as an alternative weapon for the U.S. Army's Future Attack Reconnaissance Helicopter. Considering cost-benefit considerations, it is unlikely that smart munitions or munitions with proxy fuses will be developed for this weapon, which would rely on a high rate of fire to neutralize conventional targets. Northrop Grumman considers the 30mm smart munition best suited for CUAS mission."
Yeah.